Welcome to the Account Solutions. This channel is dedicated to bring you solutions to your everyday tasks in areas of bookkeeping, business administration, accounting, and taxation. If you like what you're doing here, kindly click on the subscription button and support us. Enjoy the rest of this tutorial. From bank, like when you receive money from the bank from your customers, investors, land buyers, a loan from directors, whatever the money is for, you come to this receipt schedule and record the same thing with the payment schedule. I will not spend my time here. The same, if you understand the payment schedule, the same thing happens here. Some receipts you receive are for project code. Let me explain this. If you are receiving money from customers who have bought land and are paying small, don't post the account code to income. Post to account receivables, because there's another template that may manage all the land sales to all the customers or land buyers. So you are posting this to land sale. However, if the payments are outright payment, somebody buys the land and pay instantly, there is no connection between that person and account receivables. You just post it straight to income. Your sales income is land. There are only two account codes for land here, for sales here, which is 33110, land sales and infrastructure sales. There are the two sales income here. Other ones are service income, interest income, investment income, and other income. We have agent registration, sales commission income. It's good you go through this account chart and know all the cost and income centers here, so you know where to post an amount to, without assuming you don't have it and you just go and post everything to sales. We have income from architectural design, survey plan income, contract income, other incomes are here. So always study the account chart very well. But the two sales here are land sales. Land sales, when you just buy land, no infrastructure. The other ones, when you buy a land that has, let's say, a DPC, you know, a foundation has been laid already, you know, to the rooftop, and they buy off, that is now infrastructure. They're buying the land with the building on it. So you need to know what they are selling. Very important. So like I said in the receipt schedule, if the income that comes to the bank, the inflow, was for outright purchase of land, just post it straight to land sales income, and he hits the bank. So with your date here, let's say 1st of March 2021, my receiving account, the money was received into, let's say, Ecobank, received the money. Details, money received, you just type money received for XYZ, you know, for bland sale or anything. Partner can be your investor, can be a bank, can be a customer who paid, can be a director. Like I said, this is a long list of people. Can come to location and filter it with these two criteria here, location and partner. Just come here and to receive payment from those in Abuja, and they are all land buyers. Get list. You know, that will now filter your whole database and give you only those that are land buyers, which are already in your database. So when someone buys land and is paying small, the accountant will update the database of partners with that person's name. So that whoever is posting this thing will now see that name in the drop down list. This name is now included here. Put the details. The project code is the estate the person is buying the land from. We are selling that the estate. So we put the estate. If it's money from director or from a bank for law as a loan, just select general admin as your project code and put the account code, which can be land sales, account receivables. And I said if it's an outright purchase from the customer, just put it to land sales. But if it is paid small, any money that comes from that customer will not go to account receivables. If you are confused, ask the CFO, ask the accountant to explain to you, you know, what account code here means, and that will solve your problem. So I'm not going to post anything here, because I've explained how this works with the payment schedule. The same thing, just post. You can clear all these on to post, you can clear, but you must post your transactions. Very, very important to post your transactions. So once you've done this population here, you don't post yet. You can print it for approval, but don't post it yet. Go to your bank upload. You will see everything you've done there has appeared here. If you check, total amount to pay is 7.157 million. You check bank upload, you have 7.157 million. For First Bank Online, the first line item will be debit. I'm using First Bank to explain. So I've picked my paying account as First Bank, this account number. I've put in all my payment details inside here. Before I will print this, or if I will post to the cash book, I'll go to my bank upload. This is the First Bank Online format. You know, so the first role will pick automatically debit of the account number I want to pay from and the amount I'm paying. If you add all these things together, it gives you exactly this amount that is on the first role. So the first role will pick debit, pick the account name, the bank name I'm paying from, and pick the amount I want to pay. So if you add all this together, it gives you total sum that I want to pay. And these are all the account numbers of the partners you've selected in the payment schedule. If you count them, they are up to 14 partners. If you count this, you will get 14 account numbers. What happened here? Now the system went to this payment schedule and look for this name, this partner ID, goes to the partner's database and look up for this partner ID in the partner's database. So this ID, look up for this name, and look up for this name for the account number. So the partner ID, look up for partner name, look up for the account number, and it populates straight into this bank upload and gives you the amount you have to pay that person and the bank name. Now the official that is using this, once you have seen this is complete, is done, if there's any error, you will see an error somewhere here. Let's say for example, I remove a figure here, which is not possible. Can't remove a figure here because it's locked. Can't delete. But if there's any error, you will know. Let me see if I can create an error somewhere. Let me just see. Can create one error. You can see out of balance. Can you see it? Out of balance because it's not balancing. You have removed one name from that list, which is not giving you the accurate balance. You move the name, but you do not remove the amount from that name. You remove a partner's ID, but you didn't remove the amount. So it's giving you an error message telling you that your posting is out of balance. So you will know that it is not correct. So undo. Once you undo that, you won't see that error message anymore. So you are good to go. Now you cannot upload the entire workbook into First Bank Online Banking. That's a format which I will share now. The format you have to upload into the online banking, which I will share with you. This is a blank CSV file. That will be uploaded into the First Bank platform. Just the way it is like this. It's a CSV file. All you need to do is to go to that template and copy all the transactions, leave the headers, copy from here to the last one, Control C, or you click and copy. You go to the CSV file and just paste from A1, paste special and paste values. This is what you upload to the First Bank platform, just like this. No header, nothing else, just like this. You upload this CSV file like this, just save it in your folder, go to your First Bank Online app, upload a file and locate this file in the folder you saved it, and upload this format just the way it is like this into the bank platform and process. If there's any error, the platform will pop out the error for you, but if you do it correctly like this, you will upload it correctly well and you will make that posting to First Bank. Now you can customize this for any bank. We have just used First Bank to explain, but it can be customized for any bank based on how their own upload structure is. can customize this, but this is for First Bank Online. You can upload this format this way. The first rule shows debit account. The account to debit is your own account, and the next rule shows the accounts to credit, which are the partner's account. Could be vendors, suppliers, landlords, or anybody, sales agent. You upload their own account. That is how you upload to the banking platform using First Bank Online as an example. To continue on this template tutorial, see the next video on this playlist. Thank you for coming. Kindly subscribe to our channel if you're here to subscribe, and click on the notification bell so you get notified when we release more videos on this series. If you have been using our free templates, kindly like, share to your friends. You may know someone that knows someone that knows someone that knows someone that knows someone that may be interested in our templates. So by sharing, you're supporting what we do here. Thank you, and see you next time.